funny thing that isn't that funny to me. Last night when I was making my way from the Cosmo back to Aria, the boosted board controller was dying. The battery was dying and needed to be charged. Somehow between then and going inside last night and then leaving today, I forgot that it needed to be charged. I charged the boosted board, but I didn't charge the controller. So, I just powered on the boosted board and the controller and realized that if I use that controller, it's probably gonna die while I'm moving, and then I'm not gonna have any brakes, and then who knows what will happen. Now, I can't do that to you guys. I can't have myself smashed by a bus. You guys would have no video to watch. So, I'm gonna hoof it instead. Sandwiches at Eataly look like they would be good, and they seem, for the strip, somewhat reasonably priced, but I kind of have my heart set on this, so I'm gonna stick with the plan. Sandwich has some panini action going. By the way, did I say this? What up? It's the trooper. There's a crazy guy who was like pointing at me and mouthing something. I don't know. Just gotta watch your back, that's all. Watch your back. See the rearview mirror action? Got all this rearview mirror action right here. What was it called? The California Drip? I don't know why it would be called that. That sounds like an STD. Aside from the name, that sandwich is pretty damn good. It was somewhat spicy. There was some jalapeno action in there, and maybe pollo asado is spicy anyway? I don't know. Do I look like a pollo asado expert? I said, do I look like a pollo asado expert? Ha! Fake anger. Acting? No. I'm sure you would find this as no real surprise, but from time to time I talk about something in the vlog and then I forget that I talked about it in the vlog. And sometimes I think about talking about something in the vlog and then I fail to do so. And then sometimes I talk about something in the vlog and I edit it out. I take the whole thing out. So forgive me if I have recently spoken about this in the vlog, but I have a bit of a bone to pick with some of these food establishments in Vegas. To be a little more specific, certain types of food establishments. We're talking quick casual here. Quick casual is the one term that I can think of to call all of them. Some of them may not be, I don't know what you call. I mean, what do you call the food court at Resorts World? I call it, well, it almost seems like fast food, except that they're slow as hell sometimes. Sometimes they're really fast, but I feel like it's sort of quick casual, you know? You go, you order your shit, you pay for your shit, they call you, you go up and get your shit. I mean, it feels like quick casual. Like, what would you call that? Like Chipotle? Or is Chipotle fast food? I don't even know anymore. Allow me to get to the point. See, I'm a guy who worked for tips for a long time. Not only did I work for tips, I worked for tips in South Carolina, Myrtle Beach, for a long time. The difference between South Carolina and Nevada, let's just say, is that in South Carolina, they could pay you $2.13 per hour, plus tips. Here in Nevada, they have to pay you full minimum wage. Hey, whatever, state's laws or whatever they are, right? So when I worked at Carrabba's here for a short time and when I worked at Maggiano's here for a short time, I was paid $8.25 an hour plus tips. Well, for a server, that's really good and everything, but this was also the most expensive Carrabba's in the entire nation because of the higher pay rate that they had to give servers. So I'm a guy who's all for tips, okay? And when it comes to coffee, I feel okay about tipping for handcrafted beverages. So let's say espresso drinks or whatever. But somewhere along the way here in America, I started to see tip jars at places like McDonald's. I disagree with that. Now, to clarify my position on that, I don't care if there's a tip jar there. But somewhere along the way, again, another evolution in this mass tipping expansion that I've seen in America, we started requesting that people leave a tip before any service is actually rendered. I think we can all agree that gratuity tipping is something that you do based on service. So if gratuity should be based on, first of all, we have to agree on that, that gratuity should be based on service. If you get shitty service, then you should leave either a shitty tip or no tip at all. And this is coming from someone who worked for tips for a really long time, but here's the difference between myself and a lot of lazy, selfish servers, is that I earned every dollar that I was ever tipped. I was always the best server in the house. I was always on top of everything. And at the same time, I almost never spoke to the table unless I knew they wanted to be spoken to. You know those servers that go like, is everything okay? How you doing? Is everything all right? And then 3 minutes later, how's it going? Is everything all right? It's like, yeah, everything's all right if you would let me eat. All right, I happen to be extremely good at reading guests. Well, this is all beside the point, because I don't intend to go back to serving tables. The point is that from someone who was a server and a damn good server, you should not be tipping shitty servers. And if you see a dude sitting somewhere in a corner smoking a cigarette instead of bringing you what you need, I wouldn't tip him a nickel. Back to the point. If tipping should be based on service, then how do you justify Resorts World Food Court asking for a tip when you're at a screen in the middle of the joint, ordering yourself on a screen and then sticking your card into the little slide on the side, and then they want you to tip them 18%? Like, are they out of their minds? First of all, I haven't spoken to a human being yet. I haven't received my food. I haven't had a smile or a shitty scowl or anything yet. How can I determine what, if anything, I should be tipping you? And who the hell am I tipping? It doesn't make any sense. So when I go into Crack Shack just now and they want you to tip them, I use a card. I've gotten to the point where I don't even use a card anymore in situations like this, because if I'm gonna tip, it's gonna be after I'm satisfied, not before anything happens. So when you put your card in and they give you a slip and they want you to tip them, and all you've done is say, I want a California drip. Now, this isn't about being cheap, but even if I was, you know, filthy rich, I wouldn't throw money off of that thing right there and just let it drift down into the pool. But do you guys get my point? And maybe I've talked about this before, but I don't think I have, because if I had, it probably would have elaborated the way that I just did, and I would remember this long ass speech about tipping and gratuity. Now, let me finish this discussion by saying I am absolutely 100% pro tipping culture, pro gratuity. I am all for it. Do you understand? I'm all for it. I have no problem tipping 25, 30% sometimes if I go to a sit-down full-service restaurant. Tipping is for full service. Listen, if you want to tip a guy because you like his shoes when you're walking down the street, go right ahead. Do whatever you want to do. Doesn't bother me a bit. Listen, when I was 17 years old, I was working at Bojangles. And one morning, early, this little old lady came in and she ordered a biscuit, like a sausage biscuit. And when I went to make her biscuit for her, I noticed that the biscuits that were available to me cooked at the moment had been sitting under the heat for too long, and they were hot. They were hard on top. So I got rid of those biscuits and had them put some new biscuits in so that this lady could have a fresh biscuit. She gave me a dollar. She was like, here, get a biscuit for yourself on a break or whatever. I was like, oh, you really don't have to do that. But she made me take it. So this is coming from someone who's worked on both sides and who understands all about tipping. Believe me, if you work in a job where you're getting tipped or you're not making a lot per hour, everybody wants somebody to come up and just give them money, of course. But to require it, to request it, to beg for it, it's almost like they're begging. It's like, come on, dude. Resorts World, are you really begging me for a tip? It's off-putting, it's classless, it's in poor taste. Sounds like a poker room. I'm gonna go play poker. Shout out to Rob W. Thank you. The game was halfway decent tonight. And apparently we had the Raiders' first game going on the TV. I don't know about we had the Raiders. They had the Raiders on the TV. I could give a shit about the Raiders. Or any other football team for that matter. Not really my cup of tea or coffee, as it were. I did a little up and down escalator ride in the poker game tonight. I ended up down $31. Well, I guess that's going to do it for a Monday. Monday. I guess that was Monday Night Football action going over at the Allegiant Stadium over there. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos. Leave a comment down below. I'm going to see you next time.